Anyone? Julia? Pablo? Oliver, Jangui, Yatinku, Elias.
Perhaps more experience.
Okay, experience and good experience.
And certifications.
Good certification and oh, we can say that work ethics, right? What are the disadvantages of negative side of old age?
They're more expensive because of the experience.
Exactly. Not because of the experience, because of the health conditions, you can say that. Medical cost. Insurance cost. Insurance cost. And of course, they are old, so they would be taking more sick leaves. More insurance benefits for their transplant, for their operations. It's like that. So, one sub-diversity level of age is the difference between old age and younger age. And if we flip this side to a younger age, what are the benefits of hiring younger age? They are fresh, right? Good learner. Their learning curve is so fast. They can learn organization culture very quickly and they can adjust in an organization. All right? Low cost because they don't have any medical cost, insurance cost with them. All right?
They are more advanced in technology, for example.
Creativity, yeah, learning curve is high, so they can easily learn technology, technology oriented. All right, what are the disadvantages? First, biggest disadvantage is experience. All right, laziness, lack of life goals. Because at this age, between till 30s, most of the young people, they don't know their purpose. Whether I want to be a good teacher, I want to be a good actor, I want to be a good boss, I want to be working in finance company or merchandising company or doing my own business. So managing diversity based on age is very important. On higher level management, prefer older people. Why? Because they have good ethical practices, because they have good experience and they are working in different diverse culture and they have diverse experience as well. So they can, help in sustaining the organization's culture and well. They can easily transmit organization culture to the low level staff. So the low level management or middle management increase younger age because they are more creative, they are more tech oriented, so they have more solutions to the new problems. All right, so and they can get the work done in a matter of days, or they can quickly respond to the changes because they are more attached to social media and all those stuff, so they know what trend is going on and how to tackle that. The second orientation is gender. So there are two genders broadly, women, males or female. All right, the other variations are like we will be covering in LGBT. All right. So with the advancement or with our entrance into the 21st century, women are becoming more educated. They are given more rights, right? So they are entering into workforce at an enormous rate. So look at that. At the moment, the workforce is comprised of 47% women and 53% men. So how you are going to manage that? Even in some countries, women population is more than male population. And how to tackle that? Plus, women has other issues, and you know, with them, like managing family, raising family, right? And how you are going to tackle it? They would be needing pregnancy leave. They would be also, you know, sometimes children raising leaves are going to be taken them. So would you be comfortable to make some kind of working package that they can go to the flexible working hour? And it is happening now, right? So look, recent examples of in Corona, many women, they jumped into this online jobs, and they are not doing just one job. They are doing 5, 6, 7 jobs at a time, just working from a one laptop easily. So men, they prefer going outside. So they are very good in going to the organizations, managing the organization atmosphere and production facilities and all the stuff. The women are good. Plus, they are also looking for flexible working hours because they have other commitments with them as well. So it's very important for you as being a manager to understand the workforce diversity gender orientation. Which role best suits women? Wherever there is a flexible environment, just hire more women over there rather men. If the area is more creativity, then women are more creative than men. Hire over there. Okay. The next one is race. So race and ethnicity, basically, these are very important. Why? Because race is basically biological heritage, which include physical aspects, color of the skin, traits like heighted, short, you know, heighted person, short person, all right? So, plus, most part of the people, or majority of the people, they want to associate themselves with some race, some racial groups, all right? So, it is very important for the manager to respect the race and the characteristics with them. Ethnicity, well, the ethnicity means social traits such as cultural background, right? Or allegiance that are shared by human populations. So race means your physical traits, white, black, brown, pale, all right? Ethnicity means that your culture background, your association to them. For example, in order to, you know, more simplify the stuff, if a manager is white, he will prefer to hire white people. If a manager is Hispanic, he will prefer to hire Hispanic people. So this kind of stuff is going on in the workplace. Yes. Is there any concern? Yes, because the other people, if the surface level diversity is like that. You have every kind of, you know, race people or ethnicity people are working over there. Black, blue, brown, pale, Chinese are working, Indians are working. So if white person is hiring for only white people, then others are threatened for their future potential jobs or future potential, you know, promotions and all the stuff. So this create a discomfort and create job dissatisfaction as well. So as a manager, you are, if you must be indifferent from race and ethnicity, just see a real potential in a person, and if that person is okay or is to be hired on the basis of its own personal ability, then please hire it. There is no, you know, legal boundaries or illegal stuff that if you are a white, you need to hire white people. No. If you can find out in a given pool that this white man is good, with good experience, with good productivity skills, if you are hiring them, there is no illegal stuff. There is no ethical boundaries that are being violated. But if you are just hiring based on race and ethnicity, then you are creating discriminations. And it will be harming the organization's survival, in future profits or competitions. All right? And now, disabilities, abilities, and religion. Now, this should be debated. Now, just tell me, should an organization hire a disabled person? Guys, I need your participation.
Depends on the job, I think. If it's like a lot of physical work, like construction, why would you hire a person who can't walk, for example?
But we have technology. Now that era is finished, that you are just, you know, moving boulders through hands or through powers. You have machines, cranes. No need of leg required. You just have handlebars, lever, and that's it. And you are...
Yeah, but sir, you cannot hire someone who has a few disability of eyesight disability and put him as a pilot.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
For example. Or as a driver.
Okay. So there are some jobs, I agree, in which you cannot hire disabled. But there is a difference between disability and being handicapped. You are thinking as being the person is handicapped or no legs or this kind of stuff. So
disability, I kind of misunderstood.
Right? Disability can be a mental disability. I have all the stuff. I have my hands intact. I have my legs intact. I am pretty healthy. But I'm a slow learner. I cannot respond quickly. So I cannot be a good driver. Any changing happens, so chances are that I might caught into a heavy accident because my responsiveness is not that good. So these kind of people, they shouldn't be hired on top level management as well, because their ability to make decisions are very slow. And then being handicapped. Nowadays, with the advancement in technologies, most of the, you know, problems already been resolved. We have seen people with no legs, with no hands, even they are surviving. They have become motivational speakers. Even people, they don't have hand, they are driving the cars. They are eating, they don't need anyone help. Plus the introduction of prosthetics, limbs and bio, arms. Now things is changing very fast. So in 2050, look at that, and I am betting that many organizations will be offering these kind of products which will be helping those handicapped. All right.